Hey guys, Mr. Chu, so we're doing a short recording today. And guess what I'm cooking? Follow me. Hassa. So the kids love hassa. So I went and I purchased this at the fish store from Uncle Totoram Caribbean something something store in Fletcher, Tampa. $8 a pound. Hassa carry price like gold now. Anyway, when you want some tea, you gotta pay for it. So I'm gonna cook some hassa curry. And if you look at here, all my, I have my masala with curry powder, some onion, cilantro, my thyme. But guess what? See my hassa? I wash it clean like 3 times. And then I warm, hot some water and put the hot water in and then wash it back. So the carrot, some of the taste and some of that muddy taste and that kind of earthy taste, and also clean it well. So this is one fish you have to clean properly, right? So. I start buying the organic coconut milk. This is import from Thailand. It's very good, nice, you can taste the good flavor. So my hassa gonna have some coconut milk too. This is grind thyme, cilantro, fine thyme, broadleaf thyme, you know, a lot of different seasoning right here. Give me a few, I'm gonna be right back. You have some okra, must have some of this. Put it in. Now I'm gonna pour my curry, masala. It looks like a lot of curry powder masala, but it's a lot of hassa. When we cook hassa, we don't like to cook 1 dozen. We cook 3 dozen hassa one shot. But the kids love it. Add water a little bit at a time because I want it to cook nice and catch a little bit. Don't add too much, I'm gonna let this steam cook down. Then I'm gonna add the coconut milk and my hassa. Now with this here, I'm gonna open this coconut milk, be right back. Add my coconut milk. Thank you. This is gonna boil, let this steam down for like 7 minutes and I'll put the hassa. I don't eat meat anymore, but I still cook it for the kids. So I'm gonna do up some stew chicken so they can eat my hassa. Every time I cook fish, they don't like fish, but they eat it out. They leave the chicken, they leave the meat. Today I'm gonna monitor them now. Cooking in some stew chicken, they put some garlic and some thyme. Good, very good. Tomato paste. So this is a tomato stew chicken, huh? Put some bandana inside. Over here. Cut up the chicken, season it, black pepper, salt, some little adobo. I season it good. The water is going to help break down the tomato paste faster so it won't burn. Some of these hassas big. Real big, some small. So I'm putting the big hassa first. If you see what I'm doing, I'm putting the coconut milk inside. Putting the gravy inside of the hassa. Cover this two chicken. Let this smell good. Put in now a little hassa. let the curry, let the sauce go inside the hassa too. So the coconut milk and everything gonna go inside. Move it aside. See, cooking, you cook food is something you gotta eat and you wanna taste good. You gotta put a lot of interest into it, a lot of time. Anything you want in life, you have to put time and interest into it properly. A little bit more salt, I know. Need it. Now, it's important that water is with not salt. See all the smaller hassa up top and the big hassa at the bottom. So to make sure the big hassa cook properly, right? The smaller hassa then gonna steam nice and then go down into the curry as time goes by. Right. Chicken curry, curry chicken. Stew chicken. Look at this. You know what I mean, right? Jason, your mouth clearly leaking, right?
Yes, sir.
Can't wait for your stew chicken, eh?
Yep.
I think the hassa is completed here now. Yep. guys, thank you for subscribing. Please continue to subscribe, like, you know, review. And now starting back little by little. I want to taste this hassa curry. So look at it. This is a nice green pepper. Just cut up nice. The beauty of this curry is the coconut milk. So I clean up nice. Good. Again, you guys are doing good. This is the hassa curry. Take a little sneak peek here. Stew chicken, almost finished. So once again, thank you guys for subscribing and watch video. See you guys in the next video. This is the Cho, out.